first time in such a small plane.
Our quest for sourdough takes us up north to Skagway, Alaska. This is the place where the majority of stampeders arrived by boat from Seattle. On arrival, they still had a trip of roughly 700 kilometers to get to the gold mines, overland and up rivers. Someone who can tell us more is Susanna Dawson. She's the historian of the Klondike National Park.
Skagway was sort of the first port that stampeders arrived with all of their things. And when they got to Skagway, what they had to do was start transporting it to the gold fields, which were in Dawson. There were two trails that stampeders could take to get to the Klondike. There was the White Pass Trail is right here. People could take their horses and pack animals on that trail. Unfortunately, it was very difficult for the pack animals to be able to do that. So a lot of animals really perished on that trail, became known as the Dead Horse Trail for good reason. And then the other trail, which was in Dyea, and the Chilkoot Trail. And the Chilkoot Trail in Dyea was a trail that people traveled on by foot. There was a very steep mountain pass called the Golden Staircase that people had to traverse. The Mounties, the Canadian authorities, required each stampeder to have a year's supply of goods in order to allow them to survive in the north during the winter time so that they would not starve to death. So if you're a stampeder, you want to make sure that the stuff that you have is easy to transport. So one of the really important aspects of a stampeder's outfit was flour. Flour is great because like a 50-pound sack of flour, you can imagine it kind of conforms to your body. It's easy to balance on like lumber or a heavier, less forgiving substance. It also has the potential to become sourdough, and sourdough does not take very many ingredients. You need flour, you need water, and then all around the air we have little microbes that will come down and populate the sourdough. It was actually a real challenge to be able to make sourdough in a competent way through all of the weather and all of sort of like the climatic changes. It really takes a degree of skill to be able to keep your sourdough healthy and to cook with it. So a person who has mastered it becomes a sourdough. That's sort of a person who has earned his or her stripes in the north.
After Susanna's explanation, I decided to find out what these stampeders had to go through. Only, I was lucky enough to use a 4x4 to explore the region.
I'm on the road again.
As you can see here on this picture, people were packed. They had some carriages, but they did not realize that they had to drag this up 1,500 stairs to go over the Chilkoot Pass. I realize now why these people were called sourdoughs. If they were able to hike that trail in these conditions, maintain their starter, and bake flapjacks, hotcakes, breads in such weather conditions, you really were able to manage your sourdough. So it showed that you had a lot of expertise. Well done for these guys.
It's time to leave Skagway behind and move even further north. For, as Susanna told me, any stampeder who made it all the way to Dawson City was given the nickname Sourdough. Well, you know what? I'm about to meet one.